Greetings, Soul Star Nations of the New Eden Rising. Another night and day of powerful activations and intense waves of energy today, 8/20/2020, 2020-2022 portal. And also, today begins the new wave spell of the powerful yellow seed. From today, August 20th to September 1st, and today is Kin 144, the 144 code, and the yellow magnetic seed. Aho. The next 13 days of the Divine Goddess are going to be very intense and powerful days of activations and awakenings, with the dragon energies coming in fully now, activating our higher dimensional DNA codes to assist this great quantum leap of consciousness from Homo sapien to Homo luminous, beings of light. And then from there, we decide what form we want to take, from the formless into form, from the stillness into motion, freeing ourselves from all timelines and all time loops, and manifesting heaven on earth. We had a couple powerful blast today. We had a 23 hertz and a 60 hertz, and there was a short period of whiteout, a white band on the Schumann charts. And from Gaia perspective, it was 639 higher dimensional hertz. Again today, the whole ring of fire totally lit up, the Lemurian energy totally rising, and it started this morning in Hawaii, in the heart of Lemuria, with a 3.4 activation. Then again in the crown, in the Aleutian Islands, a 3.9. Puerto Rico, with the Atlantean energies, 3.2. A 4.4 in the Sacred Goddess Portal of Greece. And then in the Democratic Republic of Congo, in the heart of Africa, we had a 4.7. Indonesia had a 4.7 and a 4.4 earthquake. Then multiple earthquakes again in the crown in Alaska, 3.4, 3.0, Juneau, Alaska, 3.1, Kodiak Island, 3.0, Sandpoint, 3.5. So this is very active. I'm feeling it right now in my crown and in the sutures of my skull as it's expanding. And then just an hour before starting this transmission, right on the Tropic of Capricorn, in the sacred portal of Easter Island, connected with the great ascension of Gaia and all of humanity, a 4.8, which is the 12 of the goddess at 139 UTC, 22.759 latitude, 112.518 longitude. So we have the 12-12 portal, the portal to the goddess, the great Condor, the queen of the Venusians. So many powerful activations, crazy weather all over this realm, volcanoes erupting, crazy fire tornadoes in California, and storms in the clouds of other wildfires. Today, I saw an image of the only pink manta ray ever photographed, the Great Barrier Reef in Australia. So many strange phenomena in nature. These are all signs of this great awakening, this great shift, this great ascension. So we keep navigating these waves and riding them higher and higher through the vortex, through the eye of the storm, all the way to the other side, with this great unveiling and the great compression breakthrough to annihilate anything that no longer serves life or serves humanity. Aho. So today, we'll start our first transmission from Divine Sister of the Light, Lisa Marie Wright. This too shall pass. We have chosen to release all that no longer serves and embody pure, unconditional love and service to the highest good of all. As it all plays out, misaligned, dense energy is released from the planet. We are manifesting what we have created energetically onto the physical plane. Upcoming months will be challenging for many. Be kind, gentle, patient, loving with self and all. Keep flowing and glowing through it all. Know it is done. We have shifted it from the inside out. Our love has restored it all. Keep clearing final remnants of density still held within. As within, so without. The fruits of our labors are about to pay off in much more miraculous and tangible ways. Those who have embodied love are about to experience huge shifts in their tangible reality. Remaining fluid, open to limitless potential possibilities, an eternal expansion will allow all to flow with greater grace and ease. We cannot yet comprehend the heights to which we will soar, going beyond our wildest dreams. Our time has come. Let it all go. Let the true you glow. Allow yourself a clean slate. Begin anew. Trust you, what flows through you in the divine plan. Forgive self. Fully ignite the divine flame within. Release all that no longer serves and reveal your true magnificence. Expect miracles always. Your wings are ready. Now soar. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Maureen Moss. The Love Goddess rules. Get ready. Here we go. When I read this, I felt I would be remiss if I didn't post this from Star Sister Astrology. It's a great helpful forecast on our current vision quest. No matter where you are or what your life looks like from the surface, the most important things happening to you in this now moment is this. You're about to set off on a vision quest, the most important of your life. Saturday Uranus, your pipeline to quantum, lightning-like awakening, and the ruler of the grand mutation of reality that's now just over 4 months away, station retrograde in Taurus. For the third time since entering the ancient sign of our fertile, abundant, and ever-transforming Earth in May 2018, our cosmic awakener isn't even halfway through his seven-year journey through Taurus. It's the sign of Venus, and in the chart for Uranus's 2020 retrograde, the love goddess not only rules, she's at the top of the chart, tightly conjoined with the old wise moon, who will open the gates to the mysterious potency of her dark moon creation fields, almost as soon as Uranus changes direction. The near simultaneous timing of these events is a signal. Not only will the Leo new moon be suffused with the high-frequency quantum lightning of Uranus, so will the 5.5-month vision quest of the most liberated and awakened frequencies in the solar system and in your being. The reworking and reframing that's about to begin has a single purpose, to free the deep, fertile ground of your life. Every step of this vision quest is rooted in your body, your senses, and your ancient and ever-new connection with the earth. Every step will be guided by the mother of the universe within us all, and by your ability to value her fathomless creative intelligence within and around you. The sheer number of planetary conjunctions occurring as Uranus stations tell us that this vision quest begins in a field of extraordinary power. Some of those conjunctions, like that of Black Moon Lilith, Mars and Eris, and also Aphelous, Quasar, and Horus, all RX, are triple forces of energetic power. Everything in the chart of Uranus RX station speaks to the power of the 5.5 months ahead and the breakthroughs that are possible. Uranus himself is conjunct the vertex, often called the destiny point of a chart. The implications of this now moment are staggering. Here are some of the ways to maximize your ability to ride this energy like the consummate cosmic surfer you are. Every core body in the chart except the Sun and the Mars is either an Earth or a water sign. Supporting your fire and air will be vitally important. You're going to need them to avoid getting stuck in quicksand as the world around you morphs, sometimes into nightmarish apparitions. It's air and fire that will help you see the bigger picture and keep the energy moving. Move your body every day. Feel your fiery emotions and let them move through you. Feed your precious fire with breathwork and sky gazing and with deep conversation and experiences that let you see from other perspectives. Ground your body daily into the greater body of the earth, a vast transformative mystery of water with oceans that contain oceans far greater than those of the surface. Fire, exceeding the heat even of our sun's core, and crystalline minerals. She can help you uplevel your life and your physical body into an even more powerful engine of transformation. Because in the months ahead, transformation is what's going down. Feel your feelings and honor them as invaluable data. Let them move through you. Immerse yourself in the sacred waters around you as well as within you. This will let you use these times to nurture the precious, vital newness that you are already gestating. That newness within you is the future of life. Everything depends on it. What you're called to be is nothing less than the mother of the new reality. Star Sister Astrology, love, blessings, and grace to all. Maureen. Today from Divine Bro Star of the Light, Pars Kute. In this incoming cycle, our souls will be able to enter fully into the sacred union of body and soul, and they will begin to live as one. There will be no differences between body and soul, and the body will be clear to express the creative energy of the soul. Very soon, everything that we do will be an expression of soul and divine creation. We will be able to feel within our body when our souls are dancing in the light, or whether it's uncomfortable with our choices because they are not in harmony with our life plan. Then we will be gently guided to make new choices that are more in harmony, and so we will move forward on our journey, creating only unity, love, abundance, peace, compassion, harmony, and joy in our new earth reality. This process of activating the divine human template and infusing it with the divine diamond light will also be made manifest on the collective level of higher consciousness. Here we will see and feel old patterns of communal living and existing giving way to new ideas of community and new ways of being as stepping out of the divide that is perpetuating the consciousness that we are all alchemizing. To begin to unify regardless of our opinions and our beliefs about things, as communities we will also be releasing old ego and mind dominated patterns to make way for more soul-infused ways of being and interacting. Many of us will feel called to initiate new forms of community as part of our soul's mission to activate the sacred energy of Earth, and some will be guided to assist in transforming communities that already exist by infusing them with the soul light of the divine feminine and the new masculine. In this cycle, there will be increased levels of what is called ancestral healing on the individual and community and even the national level, as all that belongs to mind and ego begins to give way to structures based on heart, soul, and compassionate love. The past and the future will be changed forever as we focus into the cycle and make the changes that will determine that this timeline, time cycle of 2020, will be the one that changes everything and creates the golden future that we all seek to create and experience. With sacred love of one, Pars Kute. And today from Divine Sister of the Light, Linda Lee. Dear beloveds, the divine has started Gaia's restoration phase, which means Mother Earth's rebuilding process has begun. The rebuilding process has a lot of steps, and the first step is to tear down Gaia's old energies, which no longer serve Gaia and Mother Earth. The tearing down means a lot of movement in Mother Earth. Some of this may come as earthquakes or large volcanoes. Either way, these tearing down activities are quite intense and are going to happen around the planet. In order to stay safe and sound in this kind of climate, the divine has asked all the light workers to be vigilant and stay connected with the divine within. Always stay connected and ask for divine guidance. Know that Gaia's next phase is about rebuilding of the planet, and that means the level of earth changes and activities will be very high and unprecedented. Living on the planet now means living on the constantly changing earth, and that requires all of us to be vigilant to stay safe. In the meantime, the divine also wants all of the light workers to be heart-centered, sending heartfelt love and light to the planet and humanity. Know that now is the moment when the planet needs your light the most. Mother says to be the light and love for the planet, dear ones. Now the planet needs you, and humanity wants your help. Be their help and be Mother Earth's dedicated children. Let the planet know that you love her and you are here for her. You are always the love and warrior of the planet and humanity. Be the keeper of Mother Earth and your brothers and sisters, and let the process go as smoothly as possible. I love you, dear ones. Keep up your good work, and most importantly, stay safe and sound. Love you all, Linda Lee. Today from Divine Bro Star of the Light, Daniel Scranton. Mass awakenings have created an energetic net. The 9D Arcturian Council. Greetings, we are the Arcturian Council. We are pleased to connect with all of you. We are very excited to share with you the following transmission because we know how much you all care about the advancement of the human collective consciousness. And we have some very good news for you. You have surpassed a tipping point there on Earth with the mass awakenings that have been occurring, and as a result, you are now ready for more downloads, more activations, more attunements, more upgrades, more of everything that you have been asking for as individuals, as the awakened collective, and as the entirety of the human collective. Humanity has demonstrated enough compassion to bring about another huge surge of energies that will allow those of you who are open to hold yourselves in a high vibrational state. Even when many of your fellow humans are deciding to stay in a lower vibrational state because they think they need to, you have undoubtedly seen a lot of the anger, fear, and hate playing itself out on your world of late, and some of you may have even felt tempted to go down those paths to explore, to see whether or not they have anything worth investigating. And whether you did or did not fall down that rabbit hole, you have certainly been seeing enough trauma and tragedy on your world to open your hearts even more, to feel empathy, to feel compassion, and to offer your healing energy to humans that you have never met and may never meet. This is a time where your world has gotten even smaller, and you have been connecting with one another in ways that you couldn't even have imagined 30 or 40 years ago. But now that you feel so much more connected to other people who live on the other side of the planet, you have opened your hearts and you have allowed yourselves to feel that sympathy, that sorrow, and all of the other emotions that have come up for you because of the suffering that you know others are enduring and have endured. And that is what tipped the scales for humankind. It has been your kindness. It has been your willingness to care about others who do not look like you and who are nothing like you. And as you have extended your hearts out to those in need, you have co-created an energetic net that is above the Earth's surface that is perfectly suited to receive the next wave of energies that you have coming now, a wave of energies that you have summoned and that you have demonstrated a readiness to receive. You, the awakened collective, have done it again. You have allowed more energies in. You have grounded those energies and spread them around. And now is the time to reap the rewards. We are the Arcturian Council, and we have enjoyed connecting with you. From DanielScranton.com, and today from Divine Sister of the Light, Yukia Azora Sandara. A new dawn, an era of peace is quickening, and our beloved Gaia, beautiful sunrise, celestial and star technology, and revelation in our skies. Beloved family, sharing these ponderings, the quickening has really started long ago around 2009. That seed has been initiated or planted. A true beginning of cosmic maturity for humanity. We are now entering cosmic unity. This fills in the spaces between words, the blanks perhaps only at moments where highest potentials are activated, manifested, and reached. Now we are entering cosmic balance, but not symmetrical any longer. All parts of the cycle of our bodies contain the full totality of the energy of the full cosmos. Our holographic self is the pure reflection of the cosmic holographic balance. Each particle contains some information as the complete artwork in the canvas. The biggest breakthrough is that we have collapsed everything that did not fit any longer our previous holograms. All outdated was deleted. All memory circuits and circuitries, including letting go of all linear patterning, that 9 precedes 10, that your thoughts create the voice that speaks, that hate is the reverse of love. The old game is over. We now extend the invitation to new life and a new earth, allowing it to unfold as a continuum sequence of actions at any given moment from the infinite space of love, of brotherhood and sisterhood on earth, walking together home, welcoming cosmic maturity as energy expands or diminishes without ever losing any amount of itself. Feeling this amplification, this fullness flooding throughout our planet with these solar waves, blessings and gratitude in my heart. Infinite love, Yukia Azora Sandara, mystic-journeys.com. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Elizabeth Peru. Urgent message bringing the power back home to you. Dear cosmic community, ever since yesterday's rare, once in 33-month black new moon, the third of 4-in-1 season, the darker, often hidden aspects of the personality have been on full display. Many may be feeling the need to be right or to impose their will and opinion upon others. Know that as you do so, you weaken your power accordingly. You see, a black new moon concentrates the force of new beginnings. It also clearly exposes those who trust in their inner guidance and direction and those who do not. 2020 might seem like a challenging year, yet it's the gate opener and our transition into the Aquarian era of light, and you're here for this. You chose to be born at this right time and in the right place for your full potential to unfold and assist humanity to rise. The future is bright. From ElizabethPeru.com. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Christina Papagiorgio. From Galactic Destiny Readings, today we begin the Yellow Seed Wave Spell, Kins 144 through 156, 20 of August through the 1st of September 2020, The Power of Flowering, Targeting Awareness. The Yellow Seed Wave Spell starts with Kin 144, which is a potent DNA activator catalyzing accelerated growth. This gives you an idea of the potency of this wave spell in your soul's evolution. Kin 144 is in the 8th column of the Dzogchen calendar. The number 8, of course, represents abundance and fertility as well as flow, the in-breath and out-breath of the Creator and the infinite cycles of the universe. We have left the central core column, which represents Source, and are now traversing down the wall of this time tunnel, launching into the second part of the Dzogchen, representing the duplicate world. This is where our new creations take root. On day 3, we commence another potent journey through 10 successive gap days, which heightens the intensity of the daily energies. During these 10 days, the veil between the worlds is thinner, and it's much easier to access the Akashic records, guidance, and inspiration for your new creations. The themes that we will be exploring through this Yellow Seed Wave Spell encompass seeding, self-germination, creation, flowering, power of growth, abundance, seeding manifestation, fertile ground, gestation, opening, new possibilities, new beginnings, targeting awareness, and growing towards your highest potential. This is a period of tremendous growth potential and a fantastic opportunity to step out of your comfort zone, embrace the light, and dare to shine and blossom to incredible new heights. This applies on a personal, collective, and planetary level. We have been busy growing strong roots, and now it is time to sprout and grow tall. This is a fertile time to seed our new reality into manifesting Nova Gaia, a brilliant time to launch the new 5D projects, particularly better environmental systems and practices which are sustainable in this new paradigm. Ariel Spilsbury, author of the Mayan Oracle, extrapolates the potential of this yellow seed cycle as such. Yellow seed is the ordered pattern of growth. You and your life are the fertile soil, and the mystery blooms within you through the power of your intention or seed thoughts. Just as a seed contains the hologram of its completion, the process of manifestation follows a natural order. In this gestation process, your intention is quickened by spirit. The charged seed, your true desire or vision, becomes the focus for germination. What can you open that will support receptivity and assist the germination of your seed intentions? Envision the seed receiving the invitation to grow in the openness of your world. Viscerally feel the possibility of your heart's dream emerging. Your true desires and dreams contain an innate intelligence that can break through even the rigidity of fixed expectations. Planting a new seed, even in the hard soil of old belief systems, can bring unexpected magic and growth. Be willing to break open the constraining shells of past patterns, the shackles of belief structures. Call forth your creative involvement with life. This involvement frees and awakens the powerful energy of the life force, shifting your perceptions and experience, catalyzing the manifestation of your dreams. Participate spontaneously in your growth, unrestricted by the illusion of old structures that once provided safety. Move forward into the light of the new and greater possibilities. Tropism is the tendency to respond or move towards something by natural attraction. Through a code inherent within, a sprouted seed grows toward the light, and a sunflower follows the sun. In like manner, you respond to the light of your essence self, opening naturally to the fulfillment of your true nature. Through your own processes of living and learning, you generate and plant various intentions and desires. As your natural growth pattern is catalyzed and awakened, your truth germinates in wisdom, emerging into the light in which all seeds flourish. Thus, as you plant your own truth, more truth comes to light. In this way, you create even more fertile ground in which to explore and express all that you are, as a true starseed seeding the new reality, warning the shadow side of yellow seed is stagnation and refusal to grow, staying stuck in the mud of your old reality. The seed can choose to remain in the void of creation, the dark, damp soil beneath the earth, choosing to rot, wither, and die. However, inherently, the seed knows the path towards the light. There may be many rocks, tree roots, or obstacles in its path, but if the seed is determined, it will find its way around every obstacle in order to break out, seeking the sunshine. Remember, the small acorn has all the inherent data contained within its capsule to grow and flourish into a giant oak tree. The way out of stagnation is by being bold, courageous, and adventurous, and daring to dive into uncharted new territory. Be willing to walk through new doors, travel down new roads, and explore the potentials of what arises. This is a cycle for action, so make sure you get off that sofa and start inspiring yourself and your team to grow to new heights. So, beloved Star Blossoms, our journey during this 13-day cycle is one of awakening and opening up to more light. It is time to rise up to your greatest potential and seeding your brilliant new life. Divine blessings for seeding your new reality of greater happiness, success, and abundance. Today from the Dzogchen Times, Kin 144, Yellow Magnetic Seed. Magnetic is the name for the number one, and its key words are attract, unify, and purpose. The number one is unifying, and when we all stand together as one, we become mightier. All the days that participate in the 13-day journey form together to become one experience. The dynamism of the calendar centers around the sacred count of 13. Today, Yellow Seed is the one setting the agenda for this wave spell, and that simply means that we reap what we have sown, and now is the time we harvest this bounty. The 10 portal days in a row make this one of the only two wave spells where this occurs. Personally, I find it is not as intense as the serpent wave spell, but can it be just as eventful? Today is Yellow Seed, which represents awareness, targeting, and flowering. Things we've done in the past, good or bad, come to fruition during the flowering wave spell of the yellow seed. Many wonderful surprises happen during this time, and so much abundance. The day is also guided by yellow seed, and so a double helping of this energy. And today, from Divine Sister of the Light, Christina Papagiorgio, Yellow Magnetic Seed, Kin 144, 20 August 2020, Attracting Awareness. 28/20/20=28/22=284=14=5. 20/20/20, triple awakening code. 2, twins, partnership, cooperation. 8, abundance, infinity, source flow. 4, form, structure, foundation, earth. 5, freedom, change, transformation. Kin 144=DNA code. And 9, destiny code. A date with destiny, an extraordinary heavenly coded day for awakening and initiating your new divine destiny path. Get ready, Star Blossoms. Get out your hoe and start tilling the fertile soil as we are commencing a new 13-day wave spell today, that of the yellow seed, which is the 12th wave spell in the Dzogchen calendar. In 2 days' time, we shall also commence our descent down the slippery slide as we traverse through a column of 10 gap days in a row, souping up the energies with more intensity and power to harness your creations. Luckily, this passage will not be as unsettling as the Red Serpent Gap journey of shedding our skins. Now we are entering a very productive and fertile creation cycle. So what can we expect from the Yellow Seed Wave Spell? We can expect much more fertility, creativity, and abundance to flow into our lives through our ability to fully focus our intent and our divine missions. Greater numbers of people will begin awakening as they arise from their slumber in the deep dark soil, and they use their energy to turn towards the light, the sun, the source of light, of life, breaking ground and joining together with like-minded souls to form communities unified in their purpose. Now is the time to soul and sow all of your new ideas, Grandmother Bear coming in, and initiate new projects so that we can take root and grow. Our effort will assist us in manifesting our highest potential and seed the highest timeline for New Earth. Make sure you invest in a notebook, diary, or maybe some toilet paper. Grandma, stop. To keep with you at all times in order to record all those sparks, ideas, and inspiration you will be receiving. Make sure that you listen for the signs and promptings revealing your new direction and take inspired action to see them through and see them grow. I don't know what's happening here. Grandmother's tapping on my shoulder. I'm going to get through this. Maybe we'll let her through in the end. Tone of creation, magnetic is the tone number one in the spiritual realm as we initiate a new wave spell cycle. Power attracts, action unifies, essence, purpose. Day one of a new wave spell always starts with the magnetic tone of purpose. In the beginning was the one. From out of nothing, here one comes, spinning happily, magnetizing all that it requires for more excellent adventuring. Once strong in purpose, all will effortlessly come together. The magnetic tone is all about attraction, attracting everything that you require to fulfill your purpose and your goals. People, resources, relationships, money, support, and all that you can imagine. The attraction seeks to unify all as one. Thus, magnetic kin have a very strong connection to Source and a gravitational pull to return there and bring all their buddies with them. The power of one is very strong today as it unites us all as one humanity. What are you seeking to attract today to seed your new reality? It is a beautiful day to flower and plant new ideas in the minds of the receptive in order to target greater planetary awareness. We pray that greater numbers of the sleeping masses will awaken to the divine truth during this 13-day cycle. The more awake our collective is, the quicker we manifest our better reality. Amen to that. Spend some time in reflection during this cycle to receive more guidance from Spirit, revealing your divine mission. Our challenge is to anchor these magical energies into our physical reality in order to fully flower as the beautiful star blossoms that we all came to Earth to be. Today's question is, what projects and ideas can I seed today, allowing me to awaken and flower into my highest potential? Divine blessings for the creation of your beautiful, fertile Garden of Eden, bliss on Earth. And Lakek Alakin, Christina, White Magnetic World Bridger, Kin 66, Kin 144, Yellow Magnetic Seed. The mantra, the code today is, I unify in order to target, attracting awareness. I seal the input of flowering with a magnetic tone of purpose. I am guided by the power of my own power doubled. Can we get an amen on that one, bro stars and sisters of the light? Amen and alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I am guided by the power of my own power doubled. And that is the power of silence, the power of stillness. As we manifest with our mind and our vision and our sight, the great intuition that sees into the future, then we anchor into the stillness, visualize, and then become totally still to manifest with our highest potential and our most powerful chi. 117 coming in, 711. 117, into the most sacred 119 of the portal of the great, blessed, beloved Condor of the South. So, beloved beings of light, let us know in the comments below what you are feeling, what you're experiencing, your visions, your dreams, your synchronicities. And thank you, everyone, for sharing and expressing from your heart these many beautiful and precious things that myself and our higher dimensional team are witnessing, and it really warms our heart up that people are seeing value in these daily transmissions. It's helping them through this great shift. So we appreciate the feedback and knowing that we are making a difference in a positive way, because that is what this channel is for, and these messages and transmissions is to uplift, inspire, and activate as many light workers, love workers, star blossoms, warriors of the light, all of us, all earth angelics that came here on this great mission to ascend fully consciously, raising this whole realm with us and with Gaia. Gaia and I are one, 119, 911, the mirror of the ego flying with the condor. On earth as it is in heaven, Shakti and Shiva are here now, fully manifest, preparing to touch wings and take a great flight together. So if you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe and click the subscribe button below and the little bell to get notifications on future uploads. And as always, we have a link in the description below to the transcriptions of today's transmissions, and we archive these on our website, primedisclosure.com. I'd like to also thank everyone for their support and pledges on Patreon. I'd like to welcome and thank the Angel of the Light that made a pledge as Negative Ion. Thank you, beloved being of light, for your support. If you'd like to make a pledge, you can do so at patreon.com/primedisclosure to support my mission and my work. Now I plan on heading out very soon on my vision quest and my journey to reunite or connect with Shakti, the Great Condor, and my star, soul star family in the west, connected to the south. Our beloved angels of light, Sri and Kara, down in Tulsa Blue Mountain in Ecuador, are anchoring in the codes into our sacred portal there. And we're visioning myself and my soul star family by Mount Adams area. So multiple people have contacted me. I'm going through the messages. Some people have sent long messages and stuff. So my time is very limited right now as I'm preparing for this great journey. Now, there might be a time where I'm living out of my van. So the proceeds from Patreon and any donations will go to keeping me alive as I'm on this journey, goddess willing, as I travel through multiple portals, because being away from my soul star family and the Venusian queen is very challenging and at times traumatic to this heart that has been fully open, the dragon that has been pulled out of its cave to be totally exposed to the light as he is transforming into the white gold eagle, to take flight, to transform this realm, to assist all of you and all of humanity and all starseeds of this great awakening, 1111 coming in. And what we will transmit with this powerful family of healers and way showers is the highest love, the highest light, the highest codes. And one of these crystal children, Sri and Kara called the love child, who is carrying the energy of eternal life, the energy of five. This is Shiva in a Shakti body, one of the most rare forms, the little elven princess of the purple flower. You will all come to know them well in the near future. And we see the sanctuary, the sacred sanctuary, beautiful gardens and fountains, and all of the queen's favorite mosses. And we see a healing center and retreat. And we'll go from there. For now, if you could surround the eagle and the condor with your violet flame, your rainbow waves, your sacred flames to help assist them on this great journey. I know many of you are working on this, so we appreciate that greatly. And when you all hear the song of the condor, when she sings with her goddess voice, it will heal all minds. It will heal the world so that we can end this game of suffering and stupidity we call ignorance that is keeping humanity down in these lower waves, these lower frequencies. Last night in the middle of the night, I was awoken from a journey and my shirt was drenched wet from this intense waves of heat. And for a moment, there was this fear that came up from the deepest part of my soul where it felt like my soul spark was stolen and I was disconnected from the condor. So my etheric body jumped in and grabbed two of my most powerful tools, my weapons off of my altar, to wrap it around my heart and my left arm, that is the Venusian path, the water path, the divine feminine in the right, connected to Mars and the masculine, divine masculine, as they come together, the red and the blue, to create the purple into the violet and ultraviolet and into the silver, the gold, and the white source light into the pure, clear light of bliss. And brothers and sisters, this is just the beginning. Many great things are to come. My visions are coming moment by moment, day by day. Activations and downloads and synchronicities. Today, when I went on several sacred journeys into Pachamama and sacred portals, All day long, she was bringing me one of the most sacred kings of the river, the sacred river, the great blue heron, some of my very good friends, singing their song and calling out to me, and two crystal children, one little boy with maybe two with curly blonde hair. So I said, "Hello, little angel." He looked up at me with a huge smile, and his mother just laughed, but he was beaming this new earth light that touched my heart and activated my soul into the protector, the crazy bear, to protect all the children and our elders and all of you and all of the innocents and the angels in this realm. And then this evening, as I went on another short journey before recording this, as I was walking up again to the sacred river that one runs through this realm, that I heard this loud call, knowing it was the great blue heron again. So I looked up into the tree where he was. This massive bald eagle came swooping down and blasted me with its eagle medicine, saying, "The journey is about to begin, bro star," and flew to the north, the home of the white gold eagle. As I followed the river along the cliffs and the shale and in the mud, a big black dog came to me and transmitted a frequency, and then the eagle appeared again and flew further north, saying, "Keep going, through and through and through, brother. Do not let anything stop you. Nothing can stop us. Nothing can stop love. Not even death can stop us, because that program is ending also. There is no death. There never was. There is only death of the false, death of the fear, death of the ignorance, into the pure light, into the clear light of bliss." So feel into that energy of the great white gold eagle touching wings with the black gold condor, the sacred feminine that's already flying high above the sacred mountains, waiting for the divine masculine eagle to catch up and come to her, saying, "Rise up, rise up, rise up, sacred one. You can do this. I have faith and courage and belief in you and your abilities and your medicine. The medicine man is nothing without the power of the great medicine woman by his side. The eagle is nothing without the condor." And that is the connection, the deep bond between Shakti and Shiva as they dance through the cosmos, creating and manifesting great beauty and great harmony and balance for all life and all minds, in all timelines, all realms, all dimensions, here now, in this body that I manifest for this great mission and for this great awakening. So thank you all for joining me on this most powerful journey of the spirit. Have a beautiful and blessed day, and keep walking your sacred path with heart, warriors of the light, rising up together as one in unity consciousness. I love you all. Namaste.